In my association with Project Blue Book, I know very well that it was not a scientific project. Also, I also know that they never would notify the media when an interesting case came up. They did everything they could to
keep it down.
So they definitely withheld information.
You know, when I first interviewed Alan years ago, there was a theory going around that anybody who saw a flying saucer was probably befuddled by swamp gas somewhere in Louisiana and didn't know what he or she was seeing. We've had a lot of documentation since that time.
One of the main things that has come out here that Peter has done is to substantiate the credibility of many of the civilians, because it was easy to, and still is, to discredit a civilian. Much more difficult to discredit a military man. In Blue Book, for instance, we would get reports from military pilots, and that was particularly embarrassing to the Air Force, because after they had trained those men, and they couldn't very well, they could say that a civilian pilot might have been untrustworthy, but they could hardly say that to their own military pilots, and we got case after case after case from military pilots, which never hit the press. There are three things about this whole thing, Tom, that no one can deny. They're incontrovertible points. Even the grossest skeptic can't deny them. The first of all is that the UFO reports not only exist but persist. See, when I started with the Air Force, I thought that this was a fad, and a few years would just disappear.
Be all over, okay.
And it's global. We have reports now from 140 countries. I mean, practically as many countries as there are in the United Nations. And the most important of the three things is that many, unfortunately not all, but many of the reports come from highly, highly credible, technically trained people, you see. The phenomenon has not changed a great deal. It has not changed materially since 1947. And I'm quite sure that neither we nor the Russians had anything like the capabilities demonstrated by the UFOs in 47. I don't think we have now. So I've given up the whole idea that it could possibly be from any place on Earth.